Good afternoon, students. I hope you are all well. Today we are going to start with chapter number 10, that is understanding quadrilaterals. This chapter is on page number 164. Okay. We will do chapter number 8 afterwards. Okay. First of all, we will complete the geometry and statistics part. Now, before starting the chapter, let me remind you, because of the 30% reduction in your syllabus, I have decided to not do last two exercises of this chapter. Okay, so last two exercises will not be coming in your exams as well. Fine. So let us start with the chapter understanding quadrilaterals. So before understanding quadrilaterals, this chapter includes the definition of curves and what are curves and how do we define them. Okay, so what are curves? Curves are the plane figures which are made on a plane paper. Okay, curves are plane figures which are made on a plane figure. Okay, if I pick a pen and draw any shape, that shape will be called as a curve. Even if I'm drawing a straight line, that straight line will also be called as a curve. Okay, now we have basically two types of curves. We have open curve and closed curve. We have basically two types of curves, open curve and closed curve. What are open curve? What are closed curve? Open curves are curves in which the initial point and the final point will intersect each other are called, will never intersect each other are called open curve. Such as I am drawing this. So this is my initial point. This is my final point. These two points never interact each other. Therefore, it is called an open curve. As you can see in the diagram, this is an example of open curve and these are all three closed curve. Okay. Now, in the closed curve, you have a further definition that is called simple or not a simple curve. Okay, simple curve and not a simple curve. So how do we define what is a simple curve? What is not a simple curve? The curve which do not cross itself is called a simple curve. Like this is a simple curve, second, and this third is a simple curve. Okay, second one was a simple curve and this third one was also a simple curve. Why is so? Because the initial and final lines are meeting each other. Initial and final lines are meeting each other or not meeting each other, but the curve is not being overlapped. Okay. Suppose I make this diagram, this 8. So this 8 will be called as not a simple curve. Okay. Why? Because the curve is intersecting once again throughout the lines. Okay. Suppose you have a thread. Okay. And you place the thread in a neatly manner. Suppose you place the thread like this. So this will called a simple curve. And suppose you pick that thread in your hand, close your hand to make a fist and then throw that thread away. So this thread will be something like this. So this will be this will not be a simple curve. Okay. I guess it is understandable to you. In these four figures, second one and fourth one are not simple curves. First one and third one are simple curves. First one is open curve. Rest of the three are closed curve. Okay. For further references, you can refer to your book. This theory is also provided in your book as well. Okay. Next that we need to understand is one more thing. For every closed curve, suppose I make this as a closed curve. For every closed curve, there is an internal surface and there is an external surface. Every point inside this curve will be called the every place inside this curve will be internal surface of this curve and every surface outside the curve, every place outside this curve will be external surface to the curve. Okay. Now, next we learn about is polygon. Polygon are special type of curves. Polygon are special type of curves made up of straight lines. Polygon are special type of curve. Okay, let me see. Polygon are special type of simple curves. Students, you only need to write down the definitions that I am writing. Okay. Other theory is not required to be written in your class of copies. Okay. And all the theory, these definitions and the theories are to be done in your class of copy. In homework copy, you are supposed to do only your exercise work. So polygons are special type of simple curves. Which are made of straight lines and sharp edges. So what are straight line and sharp edges? I guess all you know this is a straight line. And what do I mean by sharp edges? See, this is a point. At this point, this line moved from here to here. There was a sharp turn in this line. Okay. This is a smooth edge. Okay. And this is a sharp edge. Okay. I take it is understandable to you. Once again, if I make an edge like this, so this edge will be a sharp edge. And if I'm curving it like this, this is a smooth edge. Okay. So polygons are special type of simple curves. Simple curves means they do not overlap each other. The lines are never overlapping each other. Okay. Polygons are closed curves. So you can see these examples. This is a polygon with four sides, again a polygon with four sides, again a polygon with four sides. Second, this is not a polygon. Why not a polygon? Because the curve, although it is closed, the curve is passing through a point. Okay, so we do not have this as a polygon. Again, this is not a polygon. The curve is repeating on itself. The curve is passing through one of its edges. So it is not a polygon. And lastly, this is also not a polygon because this is an open curve. Polygons are always a straight curve. Okay. Sorry. Moving on. Now, moving on, we have two types of polygons on the basis of their sides. If the sides of a polygon are equal, then they are called regular polygons. And if sides of a polygon are unequal, then they are called irregular polygons. If all the sides of the polygons okay, these two are part of irregular polygons. Okay, so this right angle will be also part of an irregular polygon, and this rectangle will also be a part of irregular polygon. If all the sides of a polygon are equal, like in this equilateral triangle or in this square, or in this regular pentagon or in this regular hexagon. They are called regular polygon. Okay, this will be called as a regular rectangle. This will be called as a regular triangle. This will be called as a regular pentagon. This will be called as a regular hexagon. Okay, this here will be normal pentagon. This is hexagon. This is rectangle. This is triangle. Okay. So in this manner, you have a regular figure, you have a regular polygon and an irregular polygon. What are regular polygons? If all sides are equal, then it is called an regular polygon. If sides are not equal, then it is called an irregular polygon. It doesn't matter how many sides are unequal and if pair of sides are equal and so. But if sides are equal, then it is a regular polygon. If sides are not equal, it is simply irregular polygon. Keep that in mind. Okay, next type of classification of polygon can be concave or convex polygon. Okay, so what are concave polygons? All the polygons from here to here are concave convex polygons, and all the four polygons from here to here are concave polygons. Okay, as you can understand from the names, concave polygon, their one of the edges lie near the center of the polygon. No need to write this. You just need to understand how to identify concave and convex polygon. For concave polygon, one or more of its edges lies near the center of the polygon. Okay. Or there is another definition that you can use. If diagonal of a polygon, if any diagonal of a polygon will lie outside the polygon, then it is called a concave polygon. Then it is called a concave polygon. Okay. If one of its diagonal or more of its diagonal lies outside the polygon, like for this polygon, this will be the diagonal and this diagonal is lying outside the polygon. polygon. For this polygon, let's say this is the diagonal and this diagonal is lying outside the polygon. This is the diagonal and this will lie outside the polygon. Okay. So part of the diagonal or the whole diagonal will lie outside the polygon. In that case, it is an concave polygon. For convex polygon, all of the edges are away from the center, as well as none of its diagonal are outside the polygon. Okay, all are inside the polygons. Okay, all are in the interior of the polygons. Okay, now this table, I understand it is not very clear to you, but you can understand this is number of sides, the type of polygon and its figure. If you have three sides, you have a triangle, and that this is the shape of that triangle. If you have a four-sided polygon, that will be called a quadrilateral. It is four-sided polygon. If you have five sides, then it will be called a pentagon. If you have six sides, then it is a hexagon. For seven sides, it is heptagon. फॉर एट साइड्स यू हैव ऑक्टागन, फॉर नाइन साइड्स यू हैव नॉनगन, NONAGON, नॉनागन, फॉर टेन साइड्स यू हैव डेकागन एंड सो ऑन. ओके, सो इन दिस मैनर यू हैव लॉट्स ऑफ गन्स एंड इन दिस मैनर यू नेम डिफरेंट पॉलीगन्स. ओके, सो दिस इज एन इंट्रोडक्टरी लेक्चर टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग द क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स. ओके, सो इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ कर्व्स, देन वी डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ दे आर डिफरेंट, देन वी डिस्कस अबाउट पॉलीगन्स, हाउ दे आर मेड, एंड फ्रॉम कर्व्स वॉट काइंड ऑफ कर्व्स आर पॉलीगन, वॉट काइंड ऑफ कर्व्स आर नॉट पॉलीगन. आफ्टर दैट वी डिस्कस द types of polygons, we discuss about regular and irregular polygons. Regular polygons are those polygons in which all their sides are equal. Irregular polygons, the sides are not equal. And after that, we discuss about concave and convex polygons. Okay. Now, let us come back to the chapter, original chapter, that was quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is a polygon with four sides. Okay, it has first four edges second four vertices third two diagonals sum of all the interior angle is 360 degree as well as sum of all the exterior angles is also 360 degree. Is also 360 degree. Okay, so in this manner you have a quadrilateral. What is a quadrilateral? It is a polygon that has four sides. Okay, it has four edges, four vertices, two diagonals, sum of all the interior angle is 360 degree, as well as sum of all the exterior angle is also 360 degree. If you want a figure, you can draw any type of quadrilateral. This is a quadrilateral A, B, C. Okay, so in this chapter we are mainly going to focus on concave types, convex type of quadrilaterals. We are not focusing on concave type of polygons. We will classify concave and convex type of polygons during the exercise, but we are not focusing on that. Secondly, this is an important point. Fourth point is an important point for you to solve the most of the questions. Okay, so in the exercise we will go through only two of the questions, two, three questions, okay? And we will see what, we will see the rest of the questions in the next lecture. Okay, this is question number 5 of your exercise 10.1. Please do not try question number, actually you can try all the questions, question number 1, 2, 3. Question number 4, leave it for now. We will discuss question number 4 later. Question number 1, 2, 3, I will later on give you a hint how to do question number 1, 2, 3. First of all, question number 5. On your page number 168, I could not draw all the figures. So, I borrowed the figure from a different book. Okay. So, I will name the figures as per given in the question. This is A. After that, we have this one as B. Then, this one is C. Then this one is D, star is E, and this type of figure, this goes here, this was F. Okay, this was not in your diagram, not in your book, so I will name it G. Okay, question is, classify each of the following figures on the basis of simple curve, simple, closed curve, polygon, and convex polygon, concave polygon. Okay, so let us start with the A part. Your A part will be, this is not required. Your A part will be, it is a simple curve and closed curve, so it is a simple closed curve. Secondly, it is a convex type of polygon. Let's see about B1. B1 is again simple closed curve, but it is a concave type of polygon. Next is C part. C1 again is simple closed curve, but it is not a polygon. Why it is not a polygon? Because it do not have sharp vertices. Okay, this is a curved edge. It is not a polygon. Okay, after that D part once again, it is a closed curve. And not a polygon. After that, E part. E part, it is not a simple closed curve. And again, it is not, it can be said as a polygon. Let me check the answer, please. This is exercise 10.1. And okay, E part is not a simple closed curve and not a polygon. It is not a polygon. Okay, in this manner you can do rest of them as well. F part, again it is a simple closed curve, it is concave in nature but not a polygon. Okay, it although it is concave in nature but it is not a polygon. Okay, in the answer book you are just given that which one is the simple closed curve, which one is not a simple closed curve, which one is complex polygon, which one is not a complex polygon. The answer is given that way, you can write in this way also. Next, let's see question number 7. I will come to question number 6 shortly, but first of all, let's see question number 7. Question number 7 is, the angles of a quadrilateral are in the ratio. In question number 7, it is given that the angles of a quadrilateral are in the ratio 9:7:3:5. Find the angles. Okay, so suppose this is my quadrilateral. So I am given that its angles are in the ratio of 9:7:3:5. So what I am going to let its largest angle be 9x. After that, the next angle be 7x, then 5x and 3x. How we are going to solve it? Let the angles of the quadrilaterals be. Whenever we are given in the angles in the form of ratio, we let the angles of quadrilateral or triangle or whatever type of figure is. Let the angle of this quadrilateral be 9x, 7x, 3x and 5x. Now, I have already told you sum of all the interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. That means 9x plus 7x plus 3x plus 5x is equals to 360 degree. Why so? Sum of of all interior angles is 360 degree. Okay, now we have just finished algebraic expression. Can you add 9x, 3x, 7x and 5x? See, all of these are like terms because their variable part are same. So 9x plus 7x plus 3x plus 5x, it will be 24x is equals to 360 degree. And by this, you can easily find out the value of x as 360 degree upon 24. So this is 6 4s are 24 and 6 6s are 36. 4 1s are 4 and 4 5s are 20. So value of x is 15. Once we have determined the value of x, we can determine the value of each angle. So angles are 9x is 9 into 15, that is 135 degree. 7x is 7 into 15, that is 105 degree. 3x is 3 into 15, that will be 45 degree. And 5x will be 5 into 15, that will be 75 degree. In this manner, you can determine all the angles. Okay. Now, in question number 1, if you can see in your book, in question number 1, you have to determine whether the given set of 4 angles can form a quadrilateral or not. So, what you need to do in question number 1 is, you need to add all the angles given in that option. Suppose, like it is given in option number A, you are given angles like 30 degree, 45 degree, 20 degree and 85 degree. So what you need to do is, you need to add all of these angles. 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 2, 18. Sum of all these is not equal to 360 degree. That means option A, the angles in option A will not form a quadrilateral. In this manner, you try all the other three options and you will get your answer. In the same manner, question number 2 asks, what should be the fourth angle of this pair to get a quadrilateral? So what you do is, you add all the given three angles and you subtract it from 360. Okay. Question number 3 is quite simple. We have already covered it. Okay. So that's all for today. Try to do question number 1, 2, 3, 5, 6 and 7. Leave question number 4 for now. Okay. We will discuss rest of the questions of this exercise tomorrow. For your homework, you have to do question number 6 and 7 in your homework. Okay. Try rest of the question. If you encounter any problem, kindly inform me. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day.